guys. Welcome to another AMA. It's been a while since we've done one, but thought it would be nice to record one today and talk about the EMS amp. But before I do that, I just want to point out that, guys, I got the new Z-Rec Junior t-shirt that Cherie had designed on, and it will be available at Z-Gear if you're interested. So I'm posing it and showing it off today. So, without any further ado, let's talk about the EMS. I've always had an EL34 amp in my lineup. I always loved EL34 tubes. And what I noticed a little while back is that I didn't have one. Once I kind of pulled the SRZ off of the lineup, I didn't have an EL34 amp. So I thought, well, you know, I want to make one. And I kind of thought about what I wanted to do. And, you know, the amps that always intrigued me were, you know, Jim Marshall's early designs. I've always kind of been inspired by Jim, you know, being that he was a drummer and then owned a huge amp company. Certainly was someone for me to look up to, and I do have an autographed picture of him that I keep on my wall. So I kind of looked at some of the designs that he did early on in, pretty much the 60s and 70s and 80s. And I said, you know, I want to copy these amps. I want to, you know, do a nice reproduction of these amps, but I got to do it in the Dr. Z way. You know, I can't just clone them. So I thought, well, you know, how about if I put all three circuits into one chassis and kind of make an amp that you can switch through those three vintages of Marshall amps. So basically, I've combined the JTM-50 along with the JMP-50 Mark II, which is the small box 50, and the JCM-800, which was kind of the cascaded gain or higher gain 50-watt Marshall, and kind of put them all into one enclosure. And pretty much this is it. This is the amp. It has switches that allow you to go from the cleaner input to the higher gain JCM input. And also on the back, there's a toggle switch to go from a solid state rectifier to a tube rectifier. Because as you guys know, I'm sure you're aware, the JTM 50 was pretty much Jim Marshall's copy of the Fender Bassman. And the Fender Bassman was a tube rectified amplifier. So in the first iterations, he did it with a tube rectifier, and that's kind of what this amp has. And you could switch between the solid state, more driving, dynamic solid state, or the smoother, more swelly tone of a tube rectifier. As I was designing this amp, I did find the kind of ha-ha moment that you have every time you do a design. And that was when I found the correct output tranny. The output transformer that I use on this amp is actually a duplicate of the Drake 784-139 output tranny, which was the kind of famous output tranny that he used in the early days in the Mark II 50-watt small box. As you can see, I tried to use a small box 50 head cab. And, you know, it also comes in a 2x12 combo, which is basically a blues breaker cab. And it's an amazing sounding combo, but it could probably be renamed the back breaker instead of the blues breaker, because it's pretty big and it's pretty heavy, even though it comes with casters. But that weight and that size just pays you back in tone. It's an amazing sounding amp, combo amp. But like I said, I tried to copy as best I could the cues, because, you know, guys that want Marshall amps kind of want to turn around and look and see a Marshall looking amp behind them and part of the back line, part of the look as well as the sound of the amp. Basically, those were the visual cues. It does come with an fixed extension cabinet, and this cabinet is loaded with a G12M65 Creamback, as well as a G12H30 Anniversary is the combination. I wire them in 16 ohms because, you know, British stuff and Marshall stuff kind of likes that end of the winding 16 ohm tap on a transformer to give it its best kind of output. And, you know, if you look inside the amp, basically, you know, I kind of used Mallory coupling caps, great sounding coupling caps, as well as carbon film resistors on a turret board, which is basically, you know, what Jim Marshall used initially on his initial amps. He didn't use an eyelet board like Leo Fender. He used a turret board, and to me that does have some advantages. You know, the turret board allows me to wrap the component around the turret and get a nice mechanical connection. And then you kind of solder it just to give it a kind of vibration-proof electrical connection. So it does a pretty nice job. And I kind of looked at how Jim did it, and I said, man, if it's good enough for Jim, it's good enough for Z. So that's kind of how we built it, and you can kind of see the insides. So moving along, basically, the very first circuit that's inside this amp is the JTM50. And the JTM stands for Jim and Terry Marshall. That's what the JTM stands for, if you ever wondered. And basically, it was a pretty close copy of a Fender Bassman. And on the initial units that were built, they did use a 6V6 kind of variant. I'm sorry, a 6L6 type variant in the amp. But as time went on, he kind of got a little bit more British sounding and then built it with 34s. And the 34 version was a much more popular version of the JTM. This amp was kind of known for its being recorded on the Beano album. It's John Mayall's Beano album, where he used a very young Eric Clapton, who played lead on that record. And what John Mayall was trying to achieve was the live sound that they had on stage. And that means loud driving tones. So when they recorded the Beano album, you know, John kind of pushed the engineers to try to get that big live sound, and Eric played his Les Paul plugged into the Marshall JTM, cranked pretty much. And what happened was they established kind of the groundwork for everything that came after that. The kind of distorted Les Paul Marshall sound was then put to vinyl in 1965, and everybody kind of took and improved upon or copied that from then on. Right now, I have a little audio for you guys to listen to. It's recorded by my good friend and great guitarist, Adam Gothridge. He does a cut from the Beano album. And without further ado, why don't you check it out? Now, let's take a look at the second section of this amp, which is the JMP50 Mark II, which is basically the small box 50, the one that we all know and love. That was a very prominent amp. And one of the reasons for it is that it no longer then used the tube rectifier, used the solid state rectifier. So by flicking the switch on the back of this amp, you can convert it to being a JMP 50. And think about what you're doing. You are increasing the plate voltage by using a solid state rectifier. So when you do that, you're actually increasing the bias, okay? Because you can either increase the bias voltage or increase the plate voltage, that will increase the bias current on an amp. So you will be increasing the bias basically from about 28 mA per tube with the tube rectifier to about 34 mA with the solid state. Still within the range of the tube, but now, you know, you cranked it up. So you're going to get a little bit more hair on the notes. You're going to get a little quicker distortion. You're going to also increase wattage somewhat. So it's going to be bigger, bolder, and louder. And that's basically the evolution that Jim Marshall went from the original JTM, kind of basement-ish amp, to now what's really kind of formulating the Marshall sound. You still are in the low sensitivity input, so the front end doesn't have a lot of gain, but the back end does. So the more you push it, you know, the better and bigger it sounds. So right now I'd like to turn back to my good friend Adam to do a couple more demos for you. One of them is, you know, the master of the Stratocaster, Jeff Beck. And Jeff Beck was known for his use of the 50-watt Marshall with his Stratocaster. And Adam does Lead Boots, one of the songs that Jeff Beck recorded. And then also there's a little clip of Robin Trower. Robin Trower, again, was another big 50-watt Marshall user. And I'll turn to Adam and let Adam do a little demo for you of the second section of the EMS amp. And I must say, great, great hat, Adam. I really love it. So now let's take it over to Adam. Now, the final section of the EMS is the JCM 800 section of the amp. So to engage that, You take the toggle switch and put it to high, and what that does then is then kicks in another stage or another tube, which then gives you a cascaded stage. For those of you that don't know what a cascaded stage means, it's one tube's output is driving the input of another tube to double the gain. And that's what cascaded means. So that's how the JCM-800 had its higher gain sound. You know, I did do a little bit of adjustment to the amp circuit because JCM-800s did have a tendency to be a little annoying in the high end. They could be very bright, if you will. So I kind of adjusted a bit of that out to try to give it a little bit more warmth. And then also, you know, you're able to utilize the tube rectifier with the JCM-800 circuit and give you something that's never been done before, and that's a tube rectified JCM-800. So, you know, you'll get the smoother, rounder sound and better feel under your fingers, along with a great, great gain of the JCM-800. So, you know, that is a kind of a cool capability that this amp also gives you. So, again, without further ado, I'm going to turn back to Adam to do a couple of demos for you. One from UFO, one from Ozzy, and then also the last one from Van Halen. I know Van Halen wasn't known as a JCM-800 player, but he did use a modified Marshall, and it does sound pretty good. It's a nice rendition, a little clip of Van Halen, and it will just demonstrate to you the versatility of this amp, being able to go through early Clapton and Jeff Beck and Eddie Van Halen and everything in between, as well as the classic kind of 80s rock stuff of Scorpion and UFO and Ozzy and all of those great recordings that were done in the 80s, this amp is capable of doing. So again, Adam, we'll take over and play you a little clip. And, you know, I hope you enjoyed the video. Tried to explain the amp as best I can, kind of show you it, as well as Jim Marshall. Kind of explain some of the circuitry that's in the amp and why I did it. And also sonically, you know, what it sounds like. So, thank you. Appreciate your attention. And see you again.